I Good morning. The opening hymn can be found at number 548, Joyfully Sing, number 548. Please sit.
The holy items of God, and the Solomon is spread throughout the land, even beyond Israel. And one of the people who is famous in his power, Queen of Sheba, she comes up from south from Africa to see if all this reputation that Solomon has, is it true or not? She wants to know. And so let's hear what the results of her visit to Solomon bring us.
She came to Solomon and questioned him on every subject in which she was interested. King Solomon explained everything she asked about. And there remained nothing hidden from him that he could not explain to her. When the Queen of Sheba witnessed Solomon's great wisdom in the palace, he had built the food at his table, the sitting of his ministers, the attendants and guard of his annual service. And the burnt offerings he offered in the temple of the Lord, she was breathless. The report I heard in my country about your deeds and your wisdom is true, she told the king. Though I did not believe the report until I came and saw with my own eyes, I have discovered that they were not telling me how. Your wisdom and prosperity surpassed the report I heard. Blessed are your men, blessed these servants of yours who stand before you always and listen to your wisdom. Blessed be the Lord your God, who made us pleased to place you on the throne of Israel, and his enduring love for Israel. The Lord has made you king to carry out judgment and justice. Then she gave the king 120 gold talents, a very large quantity of spices and precious gold. Never again did anyone bring such an abundance of spices as the Queen of Sheba gave to King Solomon, the Lord of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is on page 605, The Lord is My Light, number 605.
Thank you.
be with you.
Yeah.
Reading from the Holy Gospel, the good news according to Mark. Jesus called the crowd together again and said, "Pay attention and try to understand what I mean. The food that you put into your mouth doesn't make you unclean and unfit to worship God. The bad words that come out of your mouth are what make you unclean." After Jesus and his disciples had left the crowd and had gone into the house, they asked him what these sayings meant. Jesus answered, "Don't you know what I am talking to you about by now? You surely know that the food you put into your mouth cannot make you unclean. It doesn't go into your heart, but into your stomach, and then out of your body." By saying this, Jesus meant that all foods were fit to eat. Then Jesus said, "What comes from your heart is what makes you unclean. Out of your heart come evil thoughts, vulgar deeds, stealing, murder, unfaithfulness in marriage, greed, meanness, deceit, indecency, envy, insults, pride, and foolishness. All of these come from your heart, and they are what make you unfit to worship God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
About how to live your life. Just an example, it says, Give up trying so hard to get rich. Your money flies away before you know it, just like an eagle suddenly taking off. Or another thing from Proverbs, listen to instruction and do your best to learn. And then there's another book, the book of Ecclesiastes. It's another wisdom book inspired by King Solomon. And it talks about some of the deeper questions. You know, why should we live life? Why is it worthwhile? And then there's a beautiful book in here called The Song of Songs, or The Song of Solomon. And it's like a beautiful love poem between two people who love each other. And it's supposed to be used as an example of how God loves us. And then there's the Book of Wisdom. So these are ways in which some of the wisdom of Solomon come down to us. And of course, we heard about Jesus, that he's saying, you know, it's not so much what we eat or what we see or what we hear, which we, you know, a lot of people are interested, you know, I want to eat the right things so my body's going to be healthy, or I want to listen to certain things or certain songs because they make me happy. And, so we're always trying to go through the filter. What do I want to hear? And Jesus is saying, we got to hear things, see things from the world, certainly. But what really gives us a sense of who we really are is what comes from the heart. That's the part of us that really is the deepest part of who we are. When it's identified traditionally as the heart, you know, it really can't get anywhere without the heart. And, and Jesus says, you know, what we have to do is listen to what our heart is saying. And in our Catholic tradition, we have a ways of doing that. One thing we can do each day is what's called the examination of conscience. So we look at our life that day and say, you know, what made me happy? Why am I grateful? Where did I struggle and maybe go wrong? And maybe, as Jesus would say, you know, some of the things that could go wrong is when we find ourselves stealing, or we're greedy, or we're trying to trick people, or mean, or where did I go envy today, or insult others. Those are some of the things we think about, that we can think about in examination of conscience. That's coming from the heart of Jesus. Those are the things you want to let God help you prepare so that you can have a good life. We have the sacrament of confession, of reconciliation, another time when we're really forced to look at what we've done from the heart, you know, what really went wrong, where did I miss the mark? And so those are different ways in which we can follow the wisdom of Jesus when we think about our life each day. We try to share information, for instance. There are three questions we can ask. Is what we want to share truthful? Are we sure that it's really truthful? Is it necessary? The information, do I really have to share this? Like, is it needed? Is it really going to do some good? And finally, is it kind? Does it tear down people or not? When you start thinking like that, then we're letting God instruct our heart. You know, something that we want to say truthful. Do we need to say it? And is it time? So we can thank Solomon and Jesus, two very important people, especially Jesus, that we want to meet not just once, but every day. So Lord, we are right now trying to put into words what we need to share with you and to hear from you. each other what needs to be prayed for.
For church leaders, may they be wise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of our community, may we pray, be just. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the sick and suffering, may they find comfort in God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of our parish, may they trust in Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of this Mass, especially Benjamin Davison and Daniel Gutierrez, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayers. We know you will answer them with your loving care and your divine godly wisdom. This we know and is our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The song during the presentation of the gifts can be found at 521. Stand your song to the Lord, number 502. Lord, accept, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of all that you give us, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may bring us into holiness and lead to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, God our Father, who made us to live for you and for each other. We can see and speak to one another and become friends and share our joys and sorrows. And so, Father, we gladly thank you with everyone who believes in you. With the saints and angels, we rejoice and praise you, singing.
Thank you.
thank you for this. We thank you above all for your Son, Jesus Christ. You sent him into this world because people had turned away from you and no longer loved each other. Jesus opened our eyes and our hearts to understand that we are sisters and brothers and that you are Father to us all. Jesus now brings us together to one table and asks us to do what he did. Father in heaven, we ask you to bless these gifts of bread and wine and make them holy. Change them for us into the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. On the night before he died for us, Jesus had supper for the last time with his disciples. He took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke the bread and gave it to his friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, he took the cup of wine. He gave you again thanks and handed the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." And then he said, "Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Jesus now lives with you in glory, but he is also here on earth among us. And again, we thank you and say, "Glory to God in the highest." One day, Jesus will come in glory, and in his kingdom, there will be no more suffering, no more tears, no more sadness. And once more, we thank you and say, "Glory to God in the highest." Father in heaven, you have called us to receive the body and blood of Christ at this table and to be filled with the joy of the Holy Spirit. Through this sacred meal, give us strength to please you more and more. Lord our God, remember Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop, and all other bishops. Help all who follow Jesus to work for peace and to bring happiness to others. Bring us all at last together with Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, St. Hilary, St. Padre Pio, and all the saints who live with you, so we can be one in Christ in heaven. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. we share something they have taught us. And certainly right now we share something that Jesus has taught us as we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And
lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our day, that with the help of your mercy, we may be free from all sin and safe from all distress as we await in blessed hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of power and the might of the Lord
is now and forever. Our gift that Jesus gives us is his presence and his peace. And so we signal to those around us that the peace of Jesus is with us. Peace be with you.
Sunday Communion can be found at 814. Taste and see.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son, Jesus. We pray that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may help us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we are grateful for our help, extra help we get on Wednesday when our school is able to be here. Thank our seventh graders and their faith partners for helping to share the word of God and prayers, and our choir and all the others who help out. So thank you very much. When we come together next week, Wednesday, it's going to be Ash Wednesday, so we will be entering into one of our new seasons, the season of Lent. So we stay close to the Lord until we gather again. Name. So the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless us all through the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We've gathered to not only learn the teachings of Jesus, but to receive Jesus in our midst. Thanks be to God.
The recessional hymn can be found in number 512, We Are Marching, number 512. For verse 1, we will be singing We Are Marching, and for verse 2, we will be singing We Are Singing.